Hello there, my Gemini collective. I hope you're having a fantastic day. Oh my goodness, Geminis. Oh, I'm loving that Five of Swords and Scorpio energy with you. Damn, Geminis. What are you doing, Geminis? What are you doing? Oh, Geminis, some of you could have some heartbroken crosswatcher energy. Oh, those of you Geminis who've made choices in love. So, what's this vibe about, Geminis? What's this vibe about? So, Gemini, what's up here? Heartbroken crosswatcher energy. Ah, there you are, Gemini. Doing your own thing. Ace of Swords, yeah. So, those of you Geminis who made choices in love. So, heartbroken energy here. But Geminis, those of you, Seven of Cups relationships and partnerships, right? You've stayed too long. There's really no feeling. Some of you, maybe it was boredom. Maybe it was complacency with you, right? But the vibe with this, Geminis, is those of you getting ready to call in actually really good relationships and partnerships that could actually mean something. But first, you got to get out of the sort of toxic stuck-ass energy, right? And those of you Geminis who did, you did. So, you made choices, Geminis. Oh, yeah, there's that Page of Swords energy. My, oh my, Geminis. When are you not being watched? Yeah, your Page of Swords energy is Nine of Swords in it. There you are, Seven of Swords. Street smart and wise energy here, Geminis. Especially those of you that really looked at your relationships and partnerships and made some choices. You made some choices, right? So there's no illusion and confusion about what you think, feel, who you're with, right? There's that seven, yeah, healthy boundaries. That's what your focus is. Queen of Pentacles, the Page of Cups. And there's that, my, oh my, Geminis. Work, love, life energy on this, Geminis. Those of you that have sort of switched it up in all areas of your life. I definitely feel like you're far more grounded and focused than what you normally are. So if you haven't checked out your chart, maybe check out your chart. Because the individual placements could actually make a difference with you. So, bottom of the deck, you got the Strength, you got the Eight of Swords energy. There's this Ten of Pentacles. Focused on grounded relationships and partnerships. There's the Ten of Wands. There's the Five of Cups, sweeping out that sort of negative energy. The people, places, things you don't need. Geminis, this could be internal sort of releasing energy with you. Definitely relationships and partnerships, right? Seven of Swords, the Three of Cups, the High Priestess energy, the Five of Pentacles. Damn, someone's keeping readers busy cross-watching. So you're probably getting readings on you. But man... Geminis, those of you that aren't overly focused on relationships or partnerships, that makes all the difference. So a lot of you that actually made decisions, right? You're focused on healthy relationships and partnerships. Street smart and wise here. Seven of Swords with the Seven of Wands. But damn. Those of you Geminis that have chosen to stay single... So, Geminis, if you're always in a relationship or partnership, and then you sort of went your own way, started doing your own thing, focused on more grounded relationships, partnerships, work, energy, right? Your crosswatchers are keeping somebody busy, right? But crosswatchers watch because they can't see. So I like this sort of Piscean energy here with you. Damn Geminis. So, in this energy, Geminis, there's always the probability of somebody wanting to come back in, but you're more determined and focused now to have better working relationships or partnerships. Now, Gemini, you could have been the one that's in that Seven of Cups energy. So, there's two ways of looking at this, Geminis, right? Hopefully you've made decisions, you move forward, you're wanting to call in better relationships or partnerships, and that really makes all the difference. Really makes all the difference. See, there's that King of Pentacles energy, the Knight of Cups, And then there you are, Geminis. And then here's with this Ten of Cups. Geminis, don't be waiting around for relationships or partnerships to come together. If someone is slow and stagnant, right, then that's probably not the relationship that you need. Nor that you're even thinking about. My, oh, my, Geminis. My, oh, my, Geminis. A lot of you, there's personal accomplishments you need to achieve first. You could, damn, Geminis. This energy here, how long are you going to stay stuck or stagnant waiting for the right relationship or partnership? The right opportunity is going to be easy. There's going to be a natural flow to it. It's going to be easy, right? Relationships that take a while to get going, to get started, for there to be a vibe going, is why a lot of you were probably in Seven of Cups relationships or partnerships. Is this anytime soon, Geminis? For some of you, it could be further on down the road. You got to be in your vibe. You got to be making smarter choices. You come from the Seven of Cups, so you've been there, done that. So hopefully you're smarter for the journey, right? Those of you, right? You know the sort of games. You know the love games energy, that stuck sort of stagnant energy. You're aware of that, so you're making smarter choices when it comes to your relationships and partnerships. Especially if you're newly single, Geminis. Some of you, you're probably not dating. I don't feel like you're really out there doing much, Geminis. Or if you are, you're probably not on your socials. You switch something up. Because cross watchers watch because they can't see. So you're far more focused on yourself. Haunted staircase. Don't let what-ifs haunt you. Regrets, unsaid words, or missed opportunities. Geminis, I feel this is a lot of that energy that's sort of around you, right? The missed opportunities. Some of y'all, when you stop waiting for the right relationship or partnership, then the right one sort of comes in. How long are you going to stay stuck or stagnant? There's a lot of missed opportunity energy here, Geminis. But, you know, I mean, what the fuck? Did you miss the opportunity? So not staying stuck or stagnant when it comes to your relationships and partnerships. Some of y'all making decisions. Geminis, I feel like you're the one that done that. You always got this cross-watcher energy around you, right? So someone missed an opportunity. Geminis, it always feels like cross-watcher energy more with you. Because if you're doing your own thing, you're doing your own thing. Knight of Cups, there with the Geminis. Ten of Pentacles, Eight of Cups. The Moon energy. Queen of Cups. The World, the Seven of Cups, the Three of Cups. There's that Chariot. Damn. Gemini, someone didn't think you were ever going to sort of move forward and move onward. But you have. You have. And that makes all the difference. So, Geminis, keep doing the clearing work. Keep focusing on you. Geminis, some of you, you're looking at healthier relationships and partnerships. You're more street smart and wise with that Seven of Swords. So, stuck stagnant energy isn't going to work with you, right? That overly emotional, that staying stuck, is it love, whatever the fuck? How long have you been in this situation? Do they love you? Do they not? Where's this relationship going? If you're watching a lot of love readings and you get a lot of this, stuck, trapped energy. Yeah, that's really not you. But once you choose to move forward and focus on you, it makes all the fucking difference. Some of y'all could be dealing specifically with the Pisces energy. A lot of that is just that sort of stuck, stagnant energy. Right? Someone could have feelings and emotions, but if they can't speak on it and they can't sort of build and grow a relationship with you, what's the fucking point, right? So, I don't feel like you're overly romanticizing anything, Geminis. Some of you, that does make the difference. Because a lot of that sort of, whatever you've been through, you got the Seven of Wands, the Seven of Cups, and the Seven of Swords. So, there's a lot of that sort of, you've been there, done that. So, street smart and wise, healthier boundaries, making decisions. How long are you going to stay stuck in a Seven of Cups? Especially Geminis, if you've been there and done that, and it was just, there was too many what ifs, right? So there you go. You just made a decision. You made a decision. Your crosswatcher energy is like nine of swords, five of cups, but it's kind of like that. Like, they didn't think Gemini was ever going to, choose to be happy. Ooh, how long you staying stuck or stagnant, Geminis? I think a lot of you got out of that vibe. Geminis, as far as a relationship or partnership goes, I feel like you have the offers and opportunities. That's really not the thing, right? But it's sort of what your interest is now. Who sort of interests you now? I don't think you're going to stay stuck or stagnant, or you're going to wait around or really ponder things a whole hell of a lot looking at relationships. Some of you more working relationships or partnerships, so there has to be more pentacle energy in there than just that sort of, I love you, baby, but we can't build or create anything because it's too suffocating. So you're going to change your partners. You're going to change how you look at things. You're definitely smarter and wiser. Crosswatchers watch because they can't see. So a lot of you Geminis are doing your own thing. You probably switched up what you do, where you go. You're probably not on your socials. Most of you aren't on the dating sites. Someone's getting readings on you. They may say that there's a relationship coming your way. But Geminis, most of you probably don't even feel that. Or you know there could be, but that's not your main focus or your main goal right now. Geminis, a lot of you with this Ten of Pentacles energy, you're getting more sort of nested. So you're creating the right sort of environment to bring in the perfect relationship or partnership. Edge of the world, leap into the unknown, calling courage, taking risks. That's making a decision. You can stay stuck in Seven of Cups, or you can go off and do your own thing, Geminis. Neon City, the lights are blinding. Disillusionment, deception, and secrets. Some of y'all, your Jupiter placement. They say the neon lights are bright on Broadway. There's optimism with you. So that's the vibe with you. There's optimism here. Some of you, you're not staying stuck or stagnant on relationships or partnerships that really aren't going nowhere. Haven't gone nowhere. It's sort of like you're getting out of your comfort zone. So, Geminis, if you stayed too long in relationships or partnerships, right? You made a decision, now you're moving on. And guess what? It's more grounded and focused relationships or partnerships. Seven of Swords, Seven of Cups, Seven of Wands. You've been there, done that. So how long are you going to stay on that sort of loop-de-loop energy? Cosmic Highway, the universe is on your side. Signs, divine guidance, and synchronicity. Leveling up energy, Geminis. But as usual, Geminis, you notice the road sign don't match the road there. So, damn Geminis. Don't tap into that sort of crosswatcher energy, Geminis, because obviously crosswatchers watch because they can't see. So whatever you're doing, you're focused on you. It's more Ten of Pentacles energy, grounded and focused. Geminis, keep doing what the fuck it is you do. I love this vibe for you. Geminis, did you watch the Oscars? I'm Just Ken. The reference to Madonna's Material Girl video was fucking awesome, right? Damn, Geminis. Nothing's ever sort of straight with you, Geminis, right? There's always that sort of, allow the sort of diversion energy with you. But the crosswatchers watch because they can't see, because Geminis, you're just sort of always doing your own thing. Some of you, romantic relationships and partnerships, I don't think you're going to stay stuck or stagnant in that shit too long. You could have someone that wants to come forward, but if they're dragging their ass, are you really going to fuck with that? I feel like you've been there, done that, Geminis, so that's not the vibe that you're on. Once you chose you, you definitely switched it the fuck up, so that made a difference. What's with the Gemini crosswatcher vibes? Eight of Swords with the Six of Pentacles. Damn, Geminis. Who gets your time, energy, and attention? Who gets your time, energy, and attention? Geminis, those of you are avoiding those overly emotional sort of connections. You need more grounded and focused. That makes all the difference. There's a Scorpio energy. I like that vibe for you. There's the World. There's a double Five of Swords energy. There's that Four of Cups. Ooh, and there's that strength card. Geminis, the right person for you is probably going to be a very interesting sort of mix. Especially Geminis, if you're not just superficial, right? Damn Geminis. There's the Capricorn energy. There's the Ten of Cups. There's the Fool. There's the Two of Swords. Yeah, especially those of you Geminis, you were in a relationship, but it really wasn't going anywhere. So, damn. I feel like there's a level of codependency, Geminis, that you were able to sort of get free from. Especially those of you that stay in relationships far longer than what you need to. And there you are, choosing. You're making a choice. So my newly single Geminis, right? You're not exactly ready to go out there and start dating again. I like this vibe with you because you're just sort of going with the flow energy here, Geminis. I do feel there's a lot of growth with you. There's a lot of sort of clearing work with you. It's very different. It's very unique. Geminis, your choice and partners could definitely change too. My, oh my. This is the beauty, though, Geminis, when you get out of that sort of stuck energy, especially when it comes to relationships and partnerships, right? You know, that's sort of the message here. Once you make a choice, so, Geminis, some of you had to deal with some codependency. So, that could be you. That could be the relationships that you're in. Those of you that decided to just focus on you. It's made all the difference. There's not lack of an opportunity, Geminis. So a lot of you know that. If you wanted to be in a relationship, you'd be in a relationship. But you're looking for relationships that are different. I definitely feel people are getting readings on you. A lot of crosswatcher energy with you, Geminis. But you're doing your thing. Because crosswatchers watch because they can't see. So whatever you got going on, Geminis, is what the fuck you got going on, right? I don't think you feel the need to sort of broadcast everything that you're doing. Because crosswatchers watch because they can't see. Why else would they be watching, right? Someone sees relationships. So, you know, whatever this is, but Gemini, some of you, this could just be a working relationship, a healthy working relationship, right? Oh, we got the Queen of Wands there. So there's some inspiring energy around you. Nine of Pentacles, the Two of Wands, the Three of Swords, the Capricorn energy, the King of Swords. Yeah, keep doing that shadow work, Geminis. My, oh my. You doing your shadow work is having someone else sort of focus on their shadow work. Especially if they missed out on you, Geminis. I like this work energy. Those of you Geminis, if this ain't got anything to do with romance or love, right? Some of you, what you do for work, this sort of vibration that you bring, the creativity that you bring, this sort of the difference that you have. This could all be around what you do for work. You know what I mean? Or a work relationship or partnership. My, oh my, though, Geminis. You got the sun here at the bottom of the deck. So stay focused on the positive here, Geminis. There's that Sagittarius energy with you. Trusting your gut, your guidance, and your intuition. Geminis, those of you, if you haven't paid attention to the astrology around you, your astrology could definitely be sort of factoring into this. Helping you sort of get unstuck, helping you sort of move forward and look at things differently. I feel like you're more goal-oriented, Geminis. And I feel like you're single. Happily single. But yeah. There's missed opportunities around you, Geminis, but I don't know. If it was a Seven of Cups relationship or partnership, you made a choice. So you got tired of waiting around. So you pull focus back on you. Now there's some heartbroken energy. Definitely you got someone that's got some feelings or emotions. Does that mean it's going to be a good relationship for you? You'll figure that out. Crosswatcher energy. Someone's definitely getting readings on you. This Two of Cups is showing up, but I don't know, Geminis. It's kind of not the vibe. You kind of feel that too, though, don't you, Geminis? Your next partner is going to be different, Geminis. It's going to be different. It's going to be more grounded, more focused. Not so much that overly romantic shit, because you're not going to stay stuck in a relationship that's just all water and no, like, grounded energy, right? Seven of Swords, Seven of Cups with the Seven of Wands. So, you know, you kind of know all those sort of love energies. The different type of love languages, right? The different types of relationships or partnerships. As if you've been doing your shadow work, Geminis. What's the song for you, Geminis? So much fun energy. I like this with you, Gems. Get along on down the road. We've got a long, long way to go. So Gemini, some of you, relationships or partnerships ain't coming together because someone still has some work to do on themselves, right? So someone sees you're not into the regular sort of bullshit and bull crap that you might have tolerated and stayed stuck in for a while. So once you pull your energy back, right? The right person's meant to come in, they'll come in. Geminis, a lot of you are looking at new. A lot of you, your new relationship is going to be completely different. Some of you might not be till the fall with this. Love can build a bridge, right? Damn, I feel like you've been there, done that, Geminis. So how long have you stayed stuck or stagnant? You got to be the one to make that decision. A lot of you have. And then there you go. Focusing on you. Those of you that sort of getting more focused on yourself, creating more of that sort of loving environment for yourself, actually calling in the right relationships and partnerships. You'll know when the vibe is right, Geminis. You'll know when the vibe is right. If you are dating, you're being very mindful of who you date. Geminis, I feel like a lot of you just sort of changed up everything around you. So if you're coming from a relationship or partnership, you're avoiding any of the sort of energy, places, friends that sort of was attached to that. I definitely feel like you're doing the work, and that makes all the difference. So this codependency with you was probably a good thing. How long did you stay stuck before you decided to move the fuck on, Geminis? I feel like someone don't like the fact you just moved on. Yeah, you invested in yourself here. Damn, Geminis, look at you. There's a lot of this sort of taking a chance on yourself, getting out there and doing your own thing. When the right... Fuck, Geminis, someone just wants you to be a fool and fall in love. But I don't think that's your sort of energy. You're not going to go into a relationship or partnership like you did before in the past, that it was just overwhelming. Seven of Cups is like you're just treading water, right? There's so much emotion there, but there's really no ground to build or create anything off of. It's just that illusion of love. But what comes of it, right? Damn, Geminis, look at you. Geminis, some of you could definitely be focusing more on your astrology. Some of you, maybe you're doing the crystal thing. Maybe you're sort of dabbling in the esoteric. But you're not really ready. Damn, Geminis, take what's yours and leave what the fuck isn't. Is there a relationship? Yeah, but someone's a little sort of stuck. So don't sit around waiting for the right opportunity, for fuck's sake. Those of you that got out of a Seven of Cups relationship or partnership, you probably didn't miss anything. You just decided to focus on you, right? There is some heartbroken energy around you going, but that could be that sort of codependency. So, Geminis, someone was very codependent upon you, and you sort of severed that tire connection. You definitely got cross-watcher energy. Someone's watching your readings or getting readings on you. It's showing up Two of Cups, but Geminis, for some of you, that's just that sort of Gemini duality coming together. Because you had Temperance Angel. So this is that duality with you. Learning to love yourself, give to yourself, focus on yourself. Your next relationship, your next partner is going to be completely different. So whatever your expectations are, Geminis. Some of you, this is a bit on down the road. It's going to be some time for you to meet that right person. But if you're in this vibe, Geminis, you'll understand that. You're definitely trusting your gut, your guidance, and your intuition. Damn, Geminis. Take what's yours and leave what the fuck isn't, right? This is beautiful energy. Especially those of you that's creating this sort of beautiful, loving environment around you. Once you started focusing on yourself, learning to love yourself, giving to yourself, you broke a codependency. So someone misses that sort of connection they had with you, but I don't feel like you really miss anything. So, right? Be mindful, Geminis. Make smart choices. Anything else for you, Geminis? Well, let's do one more, Geminis. It's not lack of opportunities, Geminis, but for some of you, it's just, damn. You're not going to stay stuck or stagnant. So, you know what? There's kind of no pussyfooting around with you. Earth, the world keeps spinning. Completion, fulfillment, success. You're more grounded and focused than normal, Geminis. Some of you, this would definitely be your astrology, right? So, damn, look at you, Geminis. You're definitely attracting attention, Geminis. But it's focused on you. A lot of cross-watcher vibes, Geminis. But cross-watchers watch because they can't see, so... take that however that resonates for you. Especially if you've changed things up, Geminis. You've definitely changed things up. Damn. Good luck. God bless, Geminis. Take what's yours and leave what the fuck isn't. Like, share, subscribe. Keep focusing on you, Geminis.